So you have been a very studious kind of a fellow for a long time,
Not really, I think.
and I think that's what we need, statistics. मैं सोचता हूँ स्टैटिस्टिक्स के बारे में तो मेरा तो सोच के दिमाग घूम जाता है. आई फॉरगेट अबाउट गेटिंग इट ऑन पेपर एंड यू नो ट्राइंग टू सॉल्व इट. एंड आई हैव बीन अ वेरी वेरी बैड स्टूडेंट व्हेन इट कम्स टू स्टैट्स. Hi everyone, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Today I have a very special guest, Miss Twinkle Jain. She has cleared RBI Grade B DSIM examination, not DR, DSIM examination this year for 2020-2021. First of all, congratulations, Twinkle, on having clearing the examination in your first attempt itself. I think that's very, very difficult for a lot of students.
Thank you for having me.
Thanks a lot for coming here. And before starting with the actual interview, with the information that a lot of DSIM aspirants must be looking very hard for, I would want you to introduce yourself. Thoda briefly apne bare mein bataiye, whatever your work, you know, work experience or your educational background is, and then we will start with the information.
Hello, I'm Twinkle Jain, and I'm from Rajasthan, Jaipur, Rajasthan. I did graduation from Kanodia College, Jaipur. It comes under the Rajasthan University. After that, pursued post-graduation from the Rajasthan University itself. That time, I completed master's in 2020. So, after that, my interest was in research, so I decided to pursue MPhil from the Delhi University. Along with the masters, I have prepared for the ISS, Indian Statistical Services examination, for which I took classes also. And what about me next?
I think one more interesting thing is that you've cleared UGC NET twice.
I have cleared GATE twice.
GATE twice, not UGC NET.
So I am an Inspire scholar. I have getting a scholarship on the basis of my 12% from the Department of Science and Technology.
Okay, perfect. So
also,
you are
they also offered me the Inspire fellowship for the doctoral program.
Oh, amazing! So you have been a very studious kind of a fellow for a long time.
Not and, really, I think.
And I think that's what we need, statistics. मैं सोचता हूँ statistics के बारे में तो मेरा तो सोच के दिमाग घूम जाता है. I forget about getting it on paper and you know trying to solve it. And I have been a very, very bad student when it comes to stats. BCom honors में बहुत थोड़ा सा पढ़ाया करते थे, I remember. But LPP and all those things, and I have been very, very bad at it.
Yeah, they come under the operational research section.
Operational research. Yes, perfect. Okay, now let's come to the information part, because a lot of students might be interested in understanding how did you prepare for DSIM, because there is so less guidance available anywhere for this examination. Let's start with phase one. What is the pattern and what kind of questions are asked and how did you prepare for them?
First, phase one is the very basic paper, which is not very tough. Any basic with basic idea, you can clear it. And the cutoff marks is not very good of the phase one. DSIM candidates are very less already, so you have less competition here comparatively to general candidates. So in phase one, there are 20 questions. All are the objective questions and based on the statistics. And most part is from the probability inference. There are 2-3 questions also from stochastic process. If you don't know the stochastic process, I'll suggest that just read the basics of that. They'll not ask more than this. And if I'll talk about the study material for the phase one exam, I would suggest that you can refer 2-3 books of the probability and inference. One is the Mood Grable, Statistical Inference by Mood and Grable. And second is the V.K. Rohatgi book, which is a very good book for the probability and inference. I personally very, very like it, this book. Each time you'll read this book, you'll find something new. So this is very good book to refer. The past year papers are very important, which is not on the RBI website. So what to do? You have to go through the every papers which is related to statistics, like IIT JAM papers, GET examination papers, CSIR NET papers. There are one section, one unit in CSIR NET Mathematical Sciences, which is statistics. You can go through all the questions from there. At the level of the RBI phase one paper is not more than it.
So I think the sources that Twinkle has mentioned are more than enough. CSIR NET ka puta loge, that I think is good enough. And other than that, GATE level and IIT JAM, whatever she's talking about. I think if you pick up those past year papers, what she's saying is that, that the level of exam of phase one is either equal to or lesser than the level of these exams, right? So yes, that should do. That should do the trick of preparing you well when it comes to what to study, what not to study, and what level, till what level do you need to study?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Let's move to phase two now. The same process. What is the pattern? From where to prepare? And what level of questions are asked in the exam?
Phase two consists of the two papers. One is the English paper, which is of 1.5 hour. And the second is the statistical paper, which is descriptive paper of the statistics. Hmm. Here, you must know all the concept. Objective thing will not work here. And RBI always asks the tricky questions there. So you must be familiar with the concept. Like one question they ask about, which is generally people do with the simple random sampling without replacement, but they asked it about with replacement sampling. So they used a trick like I did all the derivation with that formula, which I remembered earlier. Like, after that, I have to change it immediately. And the time management also thing there, that we think that the five question is also the five question we have to do from the 18 question. There are six sections. One is the probability and sampling. Second is the inference. Third is the multivariate analysis. One is the stochastic process. Another is the computer and numerical analysis. These are the different sections.
Right.
I focused only on two sections, like I thought that focusing on every section, you must prepare only for 2-3 sections, like full syllabus of the 2-3 sections. From books, from study material, जहाँ से भी मिल रहा है वो उसका study material आप collect करके उसको full अच्छे से study करो. So I choose two sampling survey sampling design, and the second is the multivariate analysis, which these two are my favorite subjects. And choosing of these two was one of reason that these two have wider application in RBI.
Okay.
Like RBI conducts surveys, which helps them to forecast or doing these things. So and other important is the forecasting thing. Like linear models and the econometrics. These three, four criteria will these three, four subjects will help you in the interview too. So I have choose these three for my focus area.
What I'm trying to understand is, okay, you focused on these three sections. That is very good. Are there enough past year papers available on RBI website with respect to DSIM?
There are 2-3 papers or descriptive papers on the website.
So you were certain. So you were certain ki yehi 6 sections mein se paper aega.
We know the paper pattern there. Also, probability hum laga sakte hain ki sampling ka question hone ka kya chances hain, multivariate ka. Like multivariate mein se to 3 question pakka hain aayenga. तो उसमें से आप 2 क्वेश्चन अटेम्प्ट कर सकते हो वेरी इजीली. और वन चीज, वन थिंग आई रेफर्ड इन द सब्जेक्टिव पेपर इज द नेपटल कोर्सेस.
NPTEL,
NPTEL, they were very helpful for me. Like multivariate analysis I did from there and the coaching notes.
Right. I remember, maybe apne masters mein, I used to get confused very often in stats and related subjects. And I would end up on NPTEL courses only. Wahan pe 20-20 saal purane aapko lectures milenge.
But they are very step-by-step things.
Right.
Can make your own notes from there.
Right. I think those are the best sources available. वो बहुत बुड्ढे बुड्ढे टीचर्स ने पढ़ाया है लेकिन बहुत ही अच्छा पढ़ाते हैं एंड
वो एक मतलब लाइक बहुत छोटी छोटी चीज भी आपको नोट करवाते हैं, लाइक
एग्जैक्टली
इवन वो वीडियोस में बता रहे हैं हमारी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है नोट करना, बट दे मतलब लाइक ओपन करते हैं कि नहीं नहीं आप नोट कर लो इस तरीके से.
राइट 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 आई अंडरस्टैंड मुझे कुछ भी अगर समझ नहीं आ रहा है इंडेक्स नंबर्स में या किसी में भी, तो आई वुड एंड अप गोइंग देयर और वहां से क्लियर हो जाता था. आई रिमेम्बर, बट मी बीइंग अ वेरी बैड स्टूडेंट इन स्टैटिस्टिक्स, आई नो कि उसका लेवल मुझे समझ आ रहा है तो एक स्टैटिस्टिक्स वाले स्टूडेंट को तो बहुत ईजिली समझ आएगा.
Actually, I did like graduation and post-graduation both in statistics. So, at like with the second year of master's, it was easy to understand.
Right.
But you have to remember all of the things.
Right.
And as I told that the tricky questions are there.
Right, right, right. So, statistics mein choti-choti tricks hote hain, right?
नहीं, छोटे tricks नहीं होते हैं, like they you did the whole derivation earlier with SRS like WOR, लेकिन अब WR से तुम्हें सॉल्व करना है तो एकदम से वो वर्क करना, लाइक रिमेम्बर कोई थियरी तो है नहीं कि आप जस्ट कुछ बना के डाल दोगे, तो आपको वो पूरा सॉल्व करना है, इट इज लाइक डिराइव करना है और आपने पहले कभी नहीं किया है, तो इट वाज इट यूजेस माइंड, लाइक वहां पे आपको लगता है कि नहीं हमको करना पड़ेगा.
Right, right. Okay.
Or you are not sure that it is correct or not.
It is correct or not. Yes, yes. Exactly. That's the problem. So, एक बार मैं pattern थोड़ा सा repeat कर देता हूँ. As you told me before we started with this session, total of 18 questions, 6 sections. Every section has 3 questions, and a student has to write a total of 5 answers, 5 questions, but
and not more than 2.
Not more than 2 questions for from every section. So you have to take questions from 3 sections. Yes. A total of a minimum of 3 sections. So, 3 sections se to aapko questions uthane hi hai. You might decide to pick up questions from 4 sections or 5 sections also, right? You can attempt one question per section also, but it is of course advisable ki aap 3 sections cover karke jao ya 2 sections cover karke jao.
Aap aisa bhi kar sakte ho ki 2 section aap bahut acche se cover kar lo ki usme se aap 2-2 question ke liye confident ho. Like 3 mein se aap 2 attempt kar sakte ho.
Right.
और अदर सेक्शंस के लिए आप ये कर सकते हो कि सबका बेसिक्स कर दो, क्योंकि एक क्वेश्चन कहीं ना कहीं इजी आपको मिल ही जाता है इन ईच सेक्शन, और जब आप पहले से लाइक मास्टर्स इसकी एलिजिबिलिटी है मास्टर्स विद स्टैटिस्टिक्स, यू कैन नॉट अपीयर फॉर दिस एग्जाम, सो अलोंग विद द मास्टर्स आप इतना बेसिक्स को कम्प्लीट कर ही लेते हो कि उनमें से किसी एक क्वेश्चन को आप अटेम्प्ट कर पाओ.
Right.
तो आपको बस थोड़ा सा उसमें एफर्ट डालना होता है, वो हो जाता है.
Perfect, perfect. Yes, yes, I can understand that. Okay, I think that much information is enough. Okay, one more question before we move on to the interview part. Yahan is level ke liye, descriptive ke liye kahan se prepare kiya? Was your post-graduation and graduation studies enough or did you prepare specifically from some other source?
I was preparing for the Indian Statistical Services along with the master's in second. So I was taking a coaching from the Jaipur Institute. So that helped me a lot. ISS pattern is similar to this examination.
Okay, okay.
The difficulty level also similar.
Similar.
So my basics was clear from there. Like all the basics. And I had the idea as I got the guidance from there only about the RBI. So I had the idea about that. And the coaching notes helped me. Second thing is the NAPTAL course. I already told about it. And the third is the books. Like तुम्हें कुछ नहीं मिलेगा तो वो books में मिल जाएगा.
Standard books में तो उठाना पड़ेगा ही. That is
और आप बना लो notes, बना लो अपने खुद के notes बनाने पड़ेंगे. Like if you are borrowing some notes from someone, so like that will not be a help.
That will not work. Yes, क्योंकि descriptive है, you have to write, so you need to have complete understanding. Objective की तरह नहीं है कि बस tick कर दिया और आगे चल गए.
हाँ, like right. वो क्वेश्चन वैसे भी डायरेक्टली नहीं पूछते हैं और उनके क्वेश्चन बेसिकली रिपीट भी नहीं होते.
ओके ओके अमेजिंग अमेजिंग. ठीक है, लेट्स कम टू द इंटरव्यू पार्ट बिकॉज आई थिंक दे आस्क यू अ वैरायटी ऑफ क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम वैरायटी ऑफ एरियाज इन द इंटरव्यू. सो DSIM या DPR वालों को डाउट रहता है वेदर वी आर गोइंग टू बी आस्क्ड टेक्निकल क्वेश्चंस ओनली, इफ नॉट व्हाट शुड बी आवर स्कोप ऑफ प्रिपरेशन फॉर द इंटरव्यू. सो कैन यू जस्ट टेक अस बैक टू द इंटरव्यू, व्हाट हैपेंड आउट देयर, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस वर आस्क्ड.
Questions are not always technical. They can ask about anything, like anything about the economy, what government doing for the economy, what they are doing for the economy, what other regulatory bodies are doing for the economy.
Right.
Like, you can ask anything. Like, they asked about the NABARD with me, like what index they released, which can be used for the GDP forecasting. So these type of questions are there, but they don't, as a statistical person, we don't expect us to know economy in very depth. But
right.
You should have any idea about it.
Basic understanding hona chahiye.
Basic functioning aapko agar pata hai, so you can do it. Like they asked, first question, they also checked the profile first. And after that, they asked also, I'm a research student. So they asked about the research, what I'm doing there, my coursework is completed or not. So they are very cordial people and they feel after that, they started asking the technical question and the banking economy type questions. They asked about they asked very basic questions starting, profile related question. After that, there were one man who asked about the masala boom. After that, financial inclusion index. And the other question was that what other indexes RBI releases. So RBI website par kya kya cheeze hoti hain. So these type questions bhi wo kabhi kabhi pooch lete hain ki aapne wo dekha bhi hai ya nahi hai acche se. Last two उन्होंने मुझसे तो लाइक पूछा, बट उन्होंने मुझसे DSIM की फंक्शनिंग के बारे में पूछा. एज आई वाज अ DSIM कैंडिडेट, सो ही आस्क्ड अबाउट द वर्किंग ऑफ द DSIM एंड आल्सो आस्क्ड दैट व्हाट सर्वेज इट कंडक्ट्स, सो हाउ यू विल कंडक्ट द सर्वे, दिस टाइप एंड हाउ यू विल फोकस्ड द GDP. सो आई told them the methodology I remember, forecast the GDP. So they asked what will be the explanatory variable, what variables you can use to forecast the GDP, basically, in simpler words. So I told them many indexes, MSME pulse and the different, but they come to the NABARD then, that what will be the agriculture index, which is related to NABARD. तो उसमें भी वो उसे जो डिफरेंट बॉडीज है उससे रिलेट करके पूछ रहे हैं,
राइट,
सब कुछ. लाइक इट इज नॉट वेरी टेक्निकल थिंग, वो सिर्फ मेथोडोलॉजी पे फोकस करेंगे, बट वो भी तो मैं बताना चाहिए कि व्हाई दे आर यूजिंग दैट.
एप्लीकेशन पे फोकस कर रहे हैं, हाउ आर यू गोइंग टू अप्लाई दैट इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. Right. So your technical understanding of your subject, relating it with the organization that you're applying in, number one. Secondly, basics of economy, banking and finance. Uske bilkul basics pe focus kar sakte hain. Just to have an idea that you have an understanding about these things or not. Right.
Especially publications or surveys for the DSIM candidates.
उस पे काफी फोकस
कर, अगर आपको आइडिया होगा कि वो सर्वे कैसे कंडक्ट करा रहे हैं, तो आपको टेक्निकल नॉलेज भी है और आपको ये भी पता है कि वो किस क्या काम कर रहे हैं और उनका ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या है.
राइट. तो जो भी आप थ्योरेटिकली पढ़ रहे हो, हाउ आर दे अप्लाइंग इट इन रियलिटी इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, वो सर्वे में कौन से मेथड्स यूज कर रहे हैं, व्हाई आर दे यूजिंग those methodologies and not other methodologies, all those things, right? Whether they're carrying out primary survey, secondary survey, to how are they using, gathering information, sampling kaise kar rahe hain, all those things, right? Okay, perfect. So one more thing I think that you mentioned that they asked in the interview is about the department, DSIM department. So the roles and responsibilities. So basically they want to have an understanding whether you understand your roles and responsibilities or DSIM karta kya hai, right?
Yeah.
Okay, yes. Perfect.
So these I told them about the
Yes, please go ahead.
So they basically asked about the DSIM and then they carry forward the interview, according to the understanding of it.
So bahut basic interview hota hai, bahut zyada grill nahi kiya hoga, but they touched upon a lot of a variety of areas to have an understanding about
most of the questions which I don't know, I said that no I'm not aware about it or I haven't studied this. They were cool about it, ki ha theek hai, they move on like very fast. Chalo theek hai, nahi aata, this is the next, tell me this.
हाँ तो टोटल इंटरव्यू एज यू मेंशन वाज 12 to 15 मिनट्स, व्हिच इज नॉट अ लॉट. छोटा सा इंटरव्यू था एंड दे जस्ट वांटेड टू हैव अ ब्रीफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग, ब्रीफ आइडिया अबाउट योर एबिलिटी टू यू नो सर्व एज अ गुड ऑफिसर प्रॉबली इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, राइट? ओके, सो दिस वाज ऑल. एनीथिंग स्पेसिफिकली दैट यू वुड वांट टू मेंशन एंड यू नो टू ऑल द डीएसआईएम एस्पिरेंट्स जो फ्यूचर में एग्जाम देंगे उनके लिए, इफ यू हैव एनी स्पेसिफिक मैसेज और एनीथिंग दैट यू वुड वांट टू से?
I would say that the time management is also a thing there in the exam. Like if you didn't manage your time, I was working even in a company. So I left the job in 1st of March and paper was on 6th of March. So I really managed the time well there. And in the second paper, I completed one question in 1.5 hours. So So I just had 1.5 hours
for four questions.
So don't waste this time on one question only. So this is the thing I'll suggest, that time management should be there.
And I think 5 questions karna bahut important hai, otherwise you're losing out on free marks.
No, if you are doing all 3-4 questions on which you are very very confident, then you can crack it.
Okay, okay.
But I did 4.5-ish.
Okay, you did 4.5. You just did not complete one question. But 4 to aapne kiye hi kiye. So I think...
Mere paas time hi nahi tha. Like, I was run out of
time. So I think agar student 5 questions kar raha hai in those 3 hours, then he's automatically increasing his chances. Correctly kar raha hai. Aisa nahi ki incorrect wahan pe likh ke aa gaya kuch bhi.
Haan, haan. और वो मतलब बहुत वाइड एक्सप्लेनेशन नहीं करना होता है वहाँ पे. लाइक मैंने जो बहुत अच्छे से कुछ एक टॉपिक आता है तो हम वो बहुत सारा लिख देते हैं. तो वो नहीं करना है हमें, वो नहीं बताना है हमें बस उसने जो पूछा उस पर फोकस करके खत्म करना है, जस्ट टू एंड अप दैट क्वेश्चन इन वेरी क्रिस्प मैनर. इंटरव्यू में भी ये चीज वर्क करती है कि आप बहुत क्रिस्पली उनको आंसर करो विद कीवर्ड्स.
तो आई थिंक जैसे 3 घंटे हैं और 3 घंटे मतलब 16 to 3, 180 minutes, and then 5 questions. तो अगर डिवाइड करें तो हमारे पास 36 minutes के आसपास हो गए. 30 minutes ले लेते हैं तो पर क्वेश्चन 30 minutes, बट सम क्वेश्चंस विल बी इजियर, थ्योरेटिकल होंगे, कॉन्सेप्चुअल होंगी, तो उसमें कम टाइम लगेगा. सो आई थिंक मैक्स टाइम दैट यू कैन एलोकेट टू लॉन्गर क्वेश्चंस इज 1 hour. आई थिंक उसके ऊपर जा रहे हो तो कहीं ना कहीं गड़बड़ है.
हाँ, और मोस्टली ऐसा होता है कि हम पूरा पेपर पहले नहीं देखते हैं. हमें बहुत से लोग ऐसे भी होते हैं जो 15 मिनट सिर्फ ये डिसाइड करने में लग जाते हैं कि हम 18 में से कौन से क्वेश्चंस करते हैं.
राइट राइट, एंड दैट विल हैपन, दैट विल हैपन.
वो चीज नहीं करनी होती है, लेकिन लाइक तुम्हें पहले से पता होना चाहिए कि तुम्हें क्या पता है और क्या नहीं, क्योंकि दूसरी चीजें नहीं देखो. क्योंकि अगर हम ट्राई करेंगे कि हाँ हम ये भी सॉल्व कर सकते हैं तो उसमें हमारा टाइम चला जाएगा, और लास्ट में फिर जब हमारे मतलब एक अलग तरीके का प्रेशर होता है जब आपके पास टाइम नहीं होता है और आपको बहुत कुछ लिखना होता है और आपको पता है आपको बहुत कुछ आता है
आपको पता होगा कि आपको ये सेक्शंस 3 तो आते ही नहीं है ढंग से, सो यू विल नॉट वेस्ट टाइम. राइट राइट, अदरवाइज 18 गोइंग थ्रू 18 क्वेश्चंस एंड आइडेंटिफाइंग की कौन से 5 करने हैं, दैट इज गोइंग टू टेक 15-20 मिनट्स.
और सम क्वेश्चंस आर वेरी ट्रिकी दैट यू take time to understand them even. Like 5 to 10 minutes. Or some questions are very calculative. कि आपको first में नहीं समझ आ रहा है कि वो बहुत calculative है, but when you are doing it, it is very difficult. There are also on my center there were calculator were not allowed.
Oh, like, okay.
You are provided a online calculator.
Online calculator. तो वो ज़्यादा time लगता है उसमें.
उसमें calculation ही नहीं हो पाता है. बहुत time लगता है.
So those are the things that need to be kept in mind.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. ठीक है. All the very best. I think इतनी information students तक पहुंच जाएगी, that is going to be very very helpful for all the students. And thanks a lot for coming online, and thanks a lot for sharing all this information with the future aspirants. Congratulations once again. All the very best for your future. I'm certain RBI is going to be very very fortunate to have you as a researcher there.
I'm fortunate.
And you're going to have a nice time in RPI. It's a beautiful organization. Bahut maza aayega. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Thank you.